Now Domi with it into the Kane zone. Yarncroke got it back for Domi. Drive by McCabe, misses everything. Jarvis trying to clear. Jones stayed in his net. Opportunity for Domi. Backhand chance.
Oh, man. How did he make that save? Wow.
Did you see the save Saros made on Kane in Detroit last night? I honestly think this might have been better. Unbelievable. Now the question is, did he keep the club on the outside of the goal line? I think he did. They're going to take a look, I'm sure. Overhead, let's get a look. Where's the glove? Save.
Oh. Pretty close on the line, but that's a good, that's a magnificent save.
I wish Kochetkov used a dark glove because you can really get an idea of where the puck is in that white glove. What an unbelievable save. I saw the two saves last night. Saros in Detroit against Kane and Jonathan Quick, the leg, the scorpion in Florida. For me, the look is that he by a millimeter, maybe less, kept this puck on the right side of the goal line.
Well, remember, you have to have the definitive.
You've got to be able to see the puck in that glove, in the twine, clearly on the side of the goal line that has entered the cage. And I don't see it. This is the telling one. You see the puck. I don't see any separation between the puck and that red goal line. I don't see it. This will tell you more. Inconclusive there. I have this as save of the year. I think it's the best save I've seen in the National Hockey League this season.
Well, Nick Robertson is waiting to see if he's got his fifth.
I just don't see in that glove on that overhead look. You got to be able to clearly see the puck over the goal line through the glove.
After the video review, it was determined that the puck did completely cross the goal line. We have a goal.
Let's see. There's always a chance the NHL has more frames that we don't have. That one.
You know, I think the reason why they made that call, say, across the goal line, give Toronto a goal, because the game's on national television, Hockey Night Canada. That's why.
The question is, what's more time on the clock?
I think you're... Okay. It's just a shame, because what a save. So, if Stahl can win this draw clean, and you just advance the puck, even if you ice it, if he wins it, Toronto's going to really jump. They're probably going to... I don't think they have time to dump the puck in.
Pushing forward for Marner. He'll wrap it around the boards. Kochetkov to it. He'll clear it out. And the clock in Toronto finally hits zeros. And the Canes will get a much-deserved 3-2 win in Toronto.
Kochetkov wants to know what they saw, why they awarded a goal. I love this kid's charisma. What an effort he had. What an effort by the Carolina Hurricanes. Fabulous. Three wins in a row.
Oh, yeah.
Go back to
now. I'll sign the crown Toronto of Hockey Night Canada.
4 or 5. You've won the first three.
Drunk is no point. Hurricanes steal 2 points.
Canes with the win tonight. The Carolina L House will donate $200 to the Carolina Hurricanes Foundation in the Points for Kids program. The Canes' 20th win of the season.
Oh, yeah.
They're now 10-10-1 on the road. And Pyotr Kochetkov, that's a heavy hug with Jacob Slavin, and well earned, as the Canes have won 3 in a row. Well, it wasn't going to be easy tonight. Might have been smiles before the game, but make sure you were awake on this one.
Michael, oh yeah,
started it for Carolina. The power play was great. The special teams were great. And the Canes, well, they're going to come away with a great feeling to end 2023. Coming up, Hurricanes Live. We'll hear from Rob Brindamore. We'll get some analysis from Tripp. We'll hear from the Canes players and look ahead to the big matchup Tuesday at Madison Square Garden. Final in Toronto, Carolina, 3-2 winners.